I can't do anything. This is great.
Oh, good. Oh my gosh.
Please have a seat. Get comfy.
I will.
Join me.
I love your red.
Thank you. I love your yellow and your
everything. Thank you.
I would actually love to start by talking about the roles that you've played. But I'm really curious, like, what is a role that you have not played yet?
I'd like to play the corporate woman that's just really a real bee.
Now, why is that? Do you feel a connection to such a character?
Because I'm always the sweet person, you know. Mm-hmm. And in actuality, the people who are the sweetest, really, mm-hmm. play the best villains, really.
Mm.
And the people that you think are sweet.
Would you like to name some names, either now or later?
No, I won't do that.
That's fine.
But I mean, as far as what I would like to play, you know, and I do this on stage because I don't get to do it in film. Mm. Whenever you get, in, you know, the word pigeonholed, once you get pigeonholed, known for something, they just keep, they meaning the networks, they want to be safe and try this. And I love comedy. I started out doing comedy.
Did you? Like stand-up?
Yes, yes. No, not stand-up, but just doing comedy and working with Richard Pryor. I was into comedy, and that's improvisational because it's like with him, you just have to go with it. But once Color Purple came out, forget it.
Really?
All drama. Because every time there's a series that comes up that's for comedy, they go with who's safe, who's done it before.
Right.
You know,
right.
Nobody wants to take a chance.
So, speaking of a Mr. Steven Spielberg, I think that I wondered, and that I always wonder about white people being involved in helping to tell black stories. Like, you would have to, like, trust that. You know, he knows enough about the culture and the aesthetic and et cetera, et cetera. And I know that there are some projects where I'm just like, okay, you can tell, like, you know, it's black, but you can tell that, like, a white person, like, wrote this. You know what I mean?
I think with Color Purple, it was really, even though it was a black story, it was a universal story.
Yes, for sure.
It dealt with issues that every culture can deal with. That was brought to my attention when I had the ability, the opportunity to do the PR for Color Purple throughout Europe.
Oh, wow.
And we did these openings for dignitaries and the very elite people. And these women would come out with tears in their eyes because they could relate.
What did it mean to you as an actor, as a black actor, as a black woman? What did it mean to you that a white director wanted to bring this particular movie to the mainstream and tell this particular story? Like, what did it mean? What did it feel like?
Well, when I read the script, I knew that it, because like I said before, it's a universal theme. And with all the sets and the costuming and, you just needed a good director. And I think that he gave it that feeling. Now, he had said that there was a lot of controversy about him being a white man directing it. But they have to understand that Quincy Jones shot that project all over the studios. No one wanted to do it. And we didn't have any black directors that were strong. I mean, we didn't have John Singleton and all the people that have come up at this time. None of them were around that the studio would give a green light to. So Steven was the only one that said, okay, I'll do it. So it's because of him that it was even done that day. So all of you who were upset about that, that's the deal. So be quiet.
Did you know at that time that you were a part of something so big? Like, while, like, the song and, like, just the movie?
Oh, we knew it was special.
Yeah.
We knew it was special. You know, particularly me coming out of Blaxploitation films and then television, with the way it moves. And we all wanted to please Alice Walker. We wanted her to be proud.
Was she, like, around the set?
She was.
Oh, and
she well, not all the time, but it seemed to be just when I was shooting.
Of course.
And, oh my God, I hope she liked that. And I hope, oh wow. But everyone just felt the love of the story. Mm-hmm. And we all tried to do our personal best because mm-hmm. that was my first A film.
Yeah.
It was Whoopi's first film at all. For
imagine
all.
It being like your first. Like,
it was so Oprah's big. First film. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Danny was really the one that really had been doing films, mm-hmm. you know. And it was Steven's first dramatic film.
Wow.
So we all had our own personal pressures. Mm-hmm. You know, I look back and I think, oh, I wish I had enjoyed it more. Mm-hmm.